Sophia. I'm now 12 years old and I live in California. My birthday was a few days ago, so that's pretty good. And I have great news. I was picked to be on the EBSE Next Top Teacher event. So on November 25th at 9 p.m., I'm going to do a live show. So go check it out on your desktop PC or something like that. November 25th at 9 p.m. all the way to 9:50 because it's 50 minutes. And now on to our lesson, which is about Konglish, which the majority of my viewers are Korean, so they probably use Konglish a lot. But most of Konglish is pretty bad, so don't use it. And I'll explain the five different types of Konglish. First is Verbicide. As you can see, I have cut the word in half, like I usually do with harder words. Side, think of it. Spoiler. Okay. Think of side, like suicide or homicide, genocide. It all has to do with killing something. So then obviously, side means killing or to kill or something that has to do with killing. Verb is just like a verb, an action verb. In this instance, it could be used for any type of word, but mostly verbs. Verbicide, that means you kill the meaning of something. You kill the meaning of the word, the verb, the noun, mostly the verb though. You're just killing the meaning of it. So in Korea, they use 핸들 to explain the steering wheel, what you drive with. The one that looks like this. I don't know how to draw a steering wheel. And then it has like the car maker on the front. And then that's like the horn that you press. So that's like your steering wheel. And then you drive it. But Koreans call it a handle. When you translate that into English, it's handle. It's actually a word, but it doesn't mean that. This, in English, is a steering wheel. This is not a handle. A handle is the thing on the door that you grab and turn to open the door. That is a handle. This is not a handle, it's a steering wheel. So the Koreans took the word handle and made it into 핸들, which means a completely different thing than what it actually is. So that's a verbicide, just changing the meaning completely. Completely changing the meaning of a word. This is a steering wheel here in America. It's not a handle. So Konglish, if you come to America and say stuff like that, people will be really confused. Because it's like, oh, you have a nice handle when you get in the car, but then they'll get in the car and be like, there's no handle there, that's a steering wheel. And people will be very confused. So just erase that. Next is fabricated. Fabricated means just making stuff out of nowhere. It's not really the same meaning, it's just really different. They take the word and kind of like verbicide, but a little bit different. It still means the same thing, but then they just made it a little bit different and made it not sound as good, and it doesn't really make sense anymore. So Koreans call it eye shopping. If you translate that into English, it's eye shopping. That's what Koreans call eye shopping. That's what it is in English, but it really means people here in America call it window shopping. See, eye shopping, that doesn't really make sense when you write it out like that, because you're not shopping for eyeballs. There's like a shop. We sell eyes. You're not going shopping for eyes. You have your own eyes. You don't shop for eyes. You can't do that. Technology hasn't gone that far yet. So let's just draw more eyes, because it's fun. We're not going shopping for eyes. We're not eye shopping. We're window shopping. You're not really buying anything, but you're just looking through the windows and shopping for items behind the windows, basically, when you're walking and looking at shops. We are not eye shopping. That doesn't make any sense. Like, what? So that is fabricating. Just ears, most of it here. Next is phonetically different. It means the same thing, but you pronounce it differently. That's pizza. Korean people call it, oh, can I have some pizza? Pizza 좀 시켜주십니다. And stuff like that. But then in America, it's pizza. Pizza? Pizza. It's just more calm. That has a strong accent on the ja. So instead of just pizza, it's pizza. So it has a bigger accent. And it doesn't really make sense because if you write that phonetically into English, it's pizza. That doesn't look like that at all. And it sounds completely different. So follow me. Pizza. One more time, pizza. Stuff like this. Bye-bye. It still sounds the same. It means the same thing. So some types of Konglish are okay. Like this. They sound the same. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. They sound similar. And they mean the same thing. You're saying bye to someone, like you're leaving. Bye. So it basically means the same thing and sounds like the same. So I guess some types of Konglish are okay. But just in case, don't even use Konglish at all, because you might be using it wrong, and that's just, it might not make sense at all. So just in case, don't use Konglish. Next, abbreviated. Aircon. I don't know how to pronounce that, but it's like aircon, aircon, aircon. Something like that. It's like someone's like in a room and it's really hot. Aircon 틀어줬습니다. And then you say that. But then when you write it out in English, it's that. Is it some kind of convention for air? Let's all gather together and have an air convention. That doesn't make any sense. It's supposed to be air conditioner. But people just abbreviate it to aircon. Koreans. But it doesn't really make sense if you say it in English. Like, you're in a classroom, you're sitting there, it's like, teacher, can you turn on the aircon? And they won't know what that means because it's not used here. It won't make any sense because in America, con is used as an abbreviation for something else. Conventions. See? It's totally different than conditioner because we use con for a word convention, which is like a gathering of people. That's why you might hear about some stuff like Comic-Con or VidCon. It stands for conventions, not air conditioners. So make sure not to use that word here in America or when you're writing any kind of essay or anything. Because we're not all gathering to talk about air. That's just stupid. And yeah, those are my five types of English. Follow me, Verbicide. One more time, Verbicide. Next, Fabricated. Once more, Fabricated. And then, Phonetically, Different. And then, ones that are okay. And then, Abbreviated. Follow me, Abbreviated. And just in case you forgot, check out the EDSE event on November 25th at 9 p.m. on your PC or computer. That was my lesson on Konglish. Remember not to use any of these. You're allowed to use bye-bye, because that actually makes sense, but nothing else. So thank you for listening. Remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Bye!